we shall do few problems on Gauss line point form. The problem is calculate divergence of vector d at the point specified. Vector d is equal to 1 by z square 10 xyz ax cap plus 5 x square z ay cap plus 2 z cube minus 5 x square y az cap at p 2 3 5. First we'll do this problem solution. Coefficient of ax cap is dx, coefficient of ay cap is dy, coefficient of az cap is dz. The first problem is in Cartesian coordinate system. So what is dx? Dx is equal to 10 xyz divided by z square. That means 10 xy divided by z. What is dy? Dy is 5 x square z divided by z square is equal to 5 x square divided by z. What is dz? Dz is equal to 2 z cube minus 5 x square y divided by z square. So this becomes 2 z minus 5 x square y divided by z square. Again repeat, the first problem is given in Cartesian coordinates. The coefficient of ax cap is dx, coefficient of ay cap is dy, coefficient of az cap is dz. First step is to write the expressions for dx, dy and dz. Divergence of vector d in Cartesian coordinate system is a scalar given by dou dx by dou x plus dou dy by dou y plus dou dz by dou z equals dou by dou x operating on dx. Dx is what? 10 xy divided by z plus dou by dou y operating on what is dy? Dy is 5 x square z plus dou dz by dou z. Dou by dou z operating on dz, which is what? 2z minus 5 x square y divided by z square. So this has to be differentiated, and in the result we have to put 2, 3, 5. X is equal to 2, y is equal to 3 and z is equal to 5. Differentiate this. If you differentiate this, you get 10 y by z plus 5 x square. This, if you differentiate a function 5 x square by z with respect to y, the result is 0. This you differentiate with respect to z, you get 2 minus 5 x square y is constant. If you differentiate z to the power minus 2, you get minus 2 z to the power minus 3. Nx to the power n minus 1, isn't it? So you substitute letting x is equal to 2, y is equal to 3 and z is equal to 5 gives divergence of vector d is equal to 8.96 coulombs per meter cube. You may be thinking how I wrote the unit coulombs per meter cube, because divergence of d is equal to rho v. This has to be rho v, and what is the unit of rho v? Coulombs per meter cube. This is a problem asked twice or thrice in the EBT examination. Here is checking the concept of whether you know the relevant formulae in different coordinate systems to find the divergence of vector d. I'll go to now part B. Part B is given in a cylindrical coordinate system. In a cylindrical coordinate system, the coordinates are rho, phi and z. The coordinates are rho, phi and z. Coefficient of a rho cap is d rho. So what is d rho here? D rho is equal to 5 z square. Coefficient of a phi cap is d phi. D phi is 0 because no a phi cap there. coefficient of az cap is dz. What is dz? 10 rho z. These are the components d rho, d phi and dz. Now I go to solution of part B. Divergence of vector d, what is the formula? 1 by rho, dou by dou rho operating on rho into d rho plus 1 by rho dou d phi by dou phi plus dou dz by dou z is equal to 1 by dou rho operating on what is d rho? D rho is phi z square. Substitute here. So you get rho into phi z square plus 1 by rho into 0 plus dou by dou z operating on dz. Dz is what? 10 rho z. Differentiate this. 1 by rho into, differentiate this with respect to rho, you get 5z square plus 0. Differentiate this with respect to z. What you get? You get 10 rho. Letting rho is equal to 3 and z is equal to 5. Phi is not required because this expression doesn't contain phi. So rho is 3 and z is 5 gives divergence of vector d is equal to 71.67 coulombs per meter cube. Again note that divergence of vector d 71.07. Check the answers please. Divergence of vector d has to be rho v. Therefore, I have written the unit coulombs per meter cube. So, part A is solved, part B is solved. Part A was in Cartesian system, part B in cylindrical system, part C is in spherical system. 71.67. Okay. In a spherical coordinate system, the coordinates are r, theta, phi. Coefficient of ar cap is dr. So what is dr? Dr is equal to 2r sin theta sin phi. What is d phi? D phi is equal to d theta. What is d theta? Coefficient of a theta cap, which is r cos theta sin phi. Coefficient of a phi cap is d phi. What is d phi? R into cos phi. Coefficient of ar cap is dr. Coefficient of a theta cap is d theta. Coefficient of a phi cap is d phi. What is the formula for divergence of vector d in spherical coordinate system? 1 by r square dou by dou r operating on r square into dr plus 1 by r sin theta into dou by dou theta operating on d theta into sin theta plus 1 by r sin theta into dou d phi by dou phi. This is the formula. This you have to remember. Equals 1 by r square dou by dou r operating on, this is dr. Substitute dr. So what you get here? This becomes 2r cube sin theta sin phi plus 1 by r sin theta dou by dou theta operating on. Substitute d theta expression. So you get what? You get r cos theta sin phi sin theta plus 1 by r sin theta dou by dou phi operating on d phi. D phi is what? R cos phi. Now differentiate. 1 by r square into sin theta sin phi is a constant because we are differentiating partially with respect to r. 2r cube if you differentiate you get 3r square. This is a differentiation of 2r cube sin theta sin phi. Differentiate this. Plus 1 by r sin theta. See, sin theta cos theta is equal to sin 2 theta divided by 2. Since you are differentiating with respect to theta, r sin phi is a constant. Sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta by 2. If you differentiate, what you get? Half into 2 times cos 2 theta plus 1 by r sin theta. Differentiate this with respect to phi. R is a constant. Cos phi, if you differentiate, you get minus sin phi.
It does work. Half it doesn't.
Illa.
Plus work.
Plus sin. Sin 2 theta by 2. Sin 2 theta, if you differentiate, you get 2 cos theta.
Plus term number.
Plus. A small correction. This is into, not plus. Okay. So letting r is equal to 3, theta is equal to minus 45 degrees and phi is equal to minus 45 degrees, we get letting r is equal to 3, theta is equal to minus 45 degrees and phi is equal to minus 45 degrees gives divergence of vector d is equal to 2 coulombs per meter cube. So please note that this problem is given in a spherical coordinate system. Coefficient of air cap is dr. Coefficient of a theta cap is d theta. Coefficient of a phi cap is d phi. This is the expression for divergence of vector d in a spherical coordinate system. I have substituted the expressions for dr, d theta and d phi. This is the resulting equation. When you are doing differentiation with respect to r, theta and phi are constants, therefore sin theta sin phi is a constant. 2r cube, if you differentiate, you get 2 into 3r square. Here, you are differentiating with respect to theta, therefore r and sin phi are constants. Cos theta sin theta is nothing but sin 2 theta by 2. If you differentiate sin 2 theta, you get 2 cos 2 theta. Next, come to this expression, this step. Here you are differentiating with respect to phi, therefore r is a constant. R is a constant. Cos phi, if you differentiate, you get minus sin phi. Then substitute r equal to 3, theta is equal to minus 45 degrees, phi is equal to minus 45 degrees. That gives you the answer, divergence of d is equal to 2 coulombs per meter cube. We shall go to the next problem. A cube of side equal to 2 meters is centered at the origin with edges parallel to the coordinate axis. If vector d is equal to 10x cube by 3ax cap coulombs per meter square, what is the total charge contained in the cube? Do by two different methods. A standard examination problem. Solution. A cube of side 2 meters is centered at the origin. That means x varies from minus 1 to plus 1, y varies from minus 1 to plus 1, z varies from minus 1 to plus 1. Correct? Here vector d has got only one component. We find that dx is equal to 10x cube by 3 coulombs per meter square, dy equals 0 and dz equal to 0. Dx is equal to 10x cube by 3 coulombs per meter square, dy is equal to 0 and dz equal to 0. So what is a cube? According to Gauss law, we'll write the cube. The front face of the cube is at x equal to 1. Mentally assume it. The back face of the cube is at x equal to minus 1. According to Gauss law, this is first method, method 1. According to Gauss law, psi is equal to q. This implies q is equal to what psi? Closed surface integral vector d dot ds. Even though there are 6 open surface integrals, only 2 will come into play because dy is 0 and dz is 0. So this implies Q is equal to double integral. What is vector D? Dx into Ax cap. What is vector Ds? Dsx into Ax cap. The front face is at x is equal to 1. X varies from minus 1 to plus 1 because side is of 2 meters and the cube is centered at the origin. If one of the corner of the cube is the origin, then x varies from 0 to 2. Please note that. Flux is leaving the front face, therefore plus. Minus double integral. Minus sign y because flux is entering from the back face. Dx into Ax cap dot dsx into Ax cap evaluated at x equal to minus 1. Some people put here plus sign and then a minus sign is put over here. Both mean the same. Correct. A minus sign here accounts for the fact that flux entering is treated as negative, flux coming out is treated as positive. So this implies Q is equal to, what is dsx? Dsx is what? Dy into dz. Therefore, double integral, 1 for y, y varies from minus 1 to plus 1, z varies from minus 1 to plus 1, 10x cubed by 3 is dx, ax cap dot x cap is 1, dy dz at x is equal to 1, minus double integral from y equals minus 1 to plus 1, double integral z from minus 1 to plus 1, 10x cubed by 3 into dy dz evaluated at x equal to minus 1. Now 10x cubed by 3, if you put x equal to 1 in this expression, what you get? You get 10 by 3. dy if integrate you get y, limits from minus 1 to plus 1. dz if integrate you get z from minus 1 to plus 1. If you put x is equal to minus 1, you get minus 10 by 3, minus of minus it is plus, plus 10 by 3. If you integrate dy you get y between minus 1 to plus 1. dz if integrate you get z between minus 1 and plus 1. If you put here 10 by 3 into 2 into 2, that means 40 by 3. Here this also will give 40 by 3. 40 by 3 plus 40 by 3 is 80 by 3 coulombs. This is how we have done using Gauss law. Next I will go to second method. Second method, method 2. We have to get the same answer, 80 by 3 coulombs. First, we will calculate divergence of vector D. The problem is given in Cartesian coordinates. Divergence of vector D is equal to dou dx by dou x plus dou dy by dou y plus dou dz by dou z is equal to dou by dou x operating on dx. What is dx? 10x cubed by 3. These two terms are 0 because dy is 0 and dz is 0. So this becomes 10 by 3. 3x cubed, if you differentiate, you get 3x square. So this becomes 10x square. Divergence of D has to be rho v. Therefore, unit is coulombs per meter cube. This has to be rho v. We know that Q is equal to closed surface integral vector D dot ds. Applying divergence theorem, we get Q is equal to this closed surface integral is converted into volume integral. Please remember, divergence theorem is applicable only for closed surfaces. So this closed surface integral is converted into a volume integral. So instead of vector D, we have to write divergence of vector D, dv. What is dv? Dv is dx, dy, dz. Volume integral is a triple integral. x varies from minus 1 to plus 1, y varies from minus 1 to plus 1, z varies from minus 1 to plus 1. Divergence of vector d is 10x square. What is dv? Dx, dy, dz. This implies q is equal to 10. X square, if you integrate, you get x cubed by 3 between minus 1 and plus 1. Dy, if you integrate, you get y between minus 1 and plus 1. Dz, if you integrate, you get z between minus 1 and plus 1. So this is 10 into 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 into 2 into 2. So this is 10 into 2 by 3 into 2 into 2. So you get 10 into 2, 20, 20 into 4, 80. 80 by 3 coulombs. So method 1 also gave 80 by 3 coulombs. Method 2 also gave the same answer. So he has asked us to do this by two methods, means you have to solve this problem by using divergence theorem. We shall go to next problem. This is also on divergence theorem. Let me read the statement of the problem. Given vector d is equal to 5r ar cap coulombs per meter square, determine whether the divergence theorem holds good for the shell region enclosed by spherical surfaces at r equal to a and r equal to b with the condition b greater than a, and the sphere and the spherical system is centered at the origin. Solution: this problem is given in a spherical coordinate system. Coefficient of air cap is dr. So what is dr? Dr is 5r. Coulombs per meter square. No unit vector, 5, a 5 cap. Therefore, d phi is 0. No unit vector dz cap. Therefore, dz is 0. This is the first step. The mathematical statement of divergence theorem is, The mathematical statement of divergence theorem is closed surface integral vector d dot ds is equal to volume integral of divergence of vector d dv. We have to check whether this equality holds good for the spherical system given in the problem. So I'll draw two concentric spheres. This is the inner sphere of radius r equal to a. The outer sphere is of radius r equal to b. So the inner surface flux is entering. That flux I will take as phi 1. Flux entering is positive. Flux coming out is negative. So net flux psi is equal to phi 2 minus phi 1. Net flux psi is equal to psi 2 minus psi 1. Now I take left hand side of equation 1. Closed surface integral vector d dot ds must be equal to psi. Electric flux. What is psi? Psi is psi 2 minus psi 1. What is psi 2? Psi 2 is nothing but closed surface integral vector d dot ds for the outer sphere. Outer sphere means r is equal to b, minus closed surface integral vector d dot ds, correct, for the inner sphere, which is at r equal to a. What is vector d? Surface integral, double integral. What is vector d? Vector d is dr into ar cap, where dr is 5r dot. Vector ds is what? Dsr into ar cap. dSR is what? dSR is dl2 into dl3. For a spherical coordinate system, dl2 is equal to r d5. And what is dl3? dl3 is r sin theta d5. Therefore, what is dsr? What dl1 also will write? dl1 is dr. dl1 is dr. dl2 is r into d theta. dl3 is r sin theta d5. Therefore, what is dsr? dsr is equal to dl2 into dl3. dl2 into dl3 is what? R square sin theta d theta d5. So dsr is what? R square sin theta d theta d5. This is at r is equal to v minus double integral. Vector d is again what? Dr into ar cap dot dsr into ar cap. What is dr? Dr is 5r. Dr is 5r. This implies closed surface integral vector d dot ds is equal to double integral. Dr is 5 into r. dsr is what? R square sin theta d theta d5. Theta varies from 0 to pi. Phi varies from 0 to 2 pi. This is evaluated at r is equal to b minus double integral. Theta varying from 0 to pi. Phi varying from 0 to 2 pi. Five into r into r square sin theta d theta d5 evaluated at r is equal to a. Integrate. See, you put r, you get 5 r cube. Put r is equal to b. So what you get? You get 5 b cube. Sin theta if you integrate, you get minus cos theta 0 and pi. d5 if you integrate, you get 5 limits from 0 to 2 pi. Minus, you put r equal to a, you get 5 a cube. Sin theta if you integrate, you get minus cos theta between 0 and pi. d5 if you integrate 5 between 0 and 2 pi. So this becomes now 5 b cube into 2 into 2 pi minus 5 a cube into 2 into 2 pi. So this becomes 5 into 2 is 10, 10 into 2 is 20 pi, 20 pi b cube minus 20 pi a cube. Therefore, it is 20 pi into b cube minus a cube. This is the left hand side of divergence theorem. Next, we have to evaluate the right hand side. Unit of this is coulombs, because unit of flux is coulombs. Next, we will evaluate the right hand side of divergence theorem. To evaluate right hand side of divergence theorem. To evaluate right hand side of divergence theorem. First, let us calculate divergence of vector D. I again repeat, what is dr? Dr is 5r. D theta is 0. d5 is 0. So, we must know the expression for divergence of vector D in a spherical coordinate system. 1 by r square, dou by dou r, operating on r square into dr, plus 1 by r sine theta, dou theta, dou by dou theta, operating on d theta into sin theta plus 1 by r sin theta dou by dou phi operating on d phi. So this implies divergence of vector d is equal to 1 by r square dou by dou r, r square into dr. Dr if you substitute, you get 5 r cube. D theta is 0, d phi is 0, therefore the second and third terms on the right hand side become 0. So 5 r cube you differentiate with respect to r. So you get 5 into 3 times r square. If you differentiate, you get r cube 3 into r square. R square gets cancelled, you get 15 coulombs per meter cube, because divergence of d is rho v and unit of rho v is coulombs per meter cube. What is right hand side of divergence theorem? Right hand side of divergence theorem is volume integral divergence of d dv. Volume integral is a triple integral over, right, r varies from a to b, theta varies from 0 to pi, phi varies from 0 to 2 pi. Divergence of d is what? 15. What is dv? dl1 into dl2 into dl3. So 15 times r square sin theta dr d theta d phi. This is nothing but dl1 into dl2 into dl3. Now we'll integrate. 15 is a constant. R square if you integrate, you get r cube by 3. Limits between a and b. Correct. Sin theta if you integrate, you get minus cos theta 0 and pi. D phi if you integrate phi between 0 and 2 pi. So put limits now. 15 by 3 is 5. 5 times b cube minus a cube. This gives 2. This gives 2 pi. So 5 into 2 is 10. 20 pi. 20 pi into b cube minus a cube coulombs. Therefore, left hand side, right hand side is equal to left hand side. That means divergence theorem is true for a system of two concentric spheres having radii A and B. Very important point here is net flux coming out is psi 2 minus psi 1. What is entering? The flux entering is taken as negative. Flux coming out is taken as positive. This is a very, very important problem from examination point of view. We'll go to the next problem. Given vector D is equal to 10 r square phi e to the power minus r into ar cap coulombs per meter square, find the following. Rho v as a function of r. Part B, the total charge enclosed by a sphere of radius equal to a meters centered at its origin. Solution. This problem is given in a cylindrical coordinate system. So we must remember the expression for divergence of vector D in cylindrical coordinate system. Divergence of vector D is equal to 1 by rho, dou by dou rho operating on rho into d rho plus 1 by rho, dou d phi by dou phi plus dou dz by dou z. In the present problem, coefficient of vr cap is dr. So what is dr? Dr is equal to 10 r square plus 5 e to the power minus r. What is d phi? D phi is 0. Dz also is 0. Why d phi is 0? Because there is no unit vector a phi cap. Why dz is 0? Because there is no az cap unit vector. There is no unit vector az cap in the expression for vector d. So this implies divergence of vector d is equal to 1 by rho, dou by dou rho operating on, substitute d rho. So, this problem is given in a spherical coordinate system, sorry. Coefficient of vr cap is 10 r square phi e to the power minus r. What is d theta? D theta is 0, d phi is 0. Small r appears in a spherical coordinate system. I made a wrong reading, sorry for that. So what is divergence of vector d? Divergence of vector d is equal to 1 by r square, dou by dou r, operating on r square into dr, plus 1 by r sine theta, dou by dou theta, operating on d theta into sine theta, plus 1 by r sine theta, dou by dou phi, operating on d phi. These two terms vanish because d theta and d phi are 0. So this implies divergence of vector d is equal to 1 by r square dou by dou r. Dr is substitute. So r square, what you get? 10 r to the power 4 plus 5 r square e to the power minus r. This has to be differentiated now. 1 by r square, keep it out. 10 into r to the power 4, if you differentiate 4 r cube, this you differentiate using product rule, first function into differential of the second, e to the power minus r, if you differentiate with respect to r, you get minus e to the power minus r, plus 5 into e to the power minus r, r square if you differentiate, you get 2 r. So this becomes now 10 into 4 is 40, 40 r cube divided by r square plus 5 r square e to the power minus r divided by r square, that is 5 r square e to the power minus r divided by r square plus 5 into 2 r into e to the power minus r divided by r square. So this becomes 40. This becomes 40 r minus, this becomes 5 into e to the power minus r plus 10 into e to the power minus r divided by r. This is the expression for divergence of D. Unit of divergence of D is coulombs per meter cube, because divergence of D is rho v. This is the expression for divergence of vector D. Okay. Next we have divergence of vector D has to be rho v, since rho v is equal to divergence of D, this is the x, this is the answer. What is the answer? 40 into r minus 5 into e to the power minus r plus 10 e to the power minus r divided by r coulombs per meter cube. This is the expression for rho v as a function of r. Next, find the total charge enclosed by a sphere of radius r equal to a centered about the origin. This can be done by two methods. But easiest method is, say, part B. Q is equal to, according to Gauss law, psi is equal to Q, which implies Q is equal to psi is equal to closed surface integral vector D dot ds. This is method 1. This implies Q is equal to closed surface integral. What is vector D? Vector D is dr into ar cap dot dsr. Whatever unit vector D contains, same unit vector ds also must contain. Dsr into ar cap. So, closed surface integral is a double integral. Correct? What is dr? Dr is 10 r square plus 5 e to the power minus r. What is dsr? Dsr is r square sine theta d phi. And what is the value of r evaluated at r equal to a? So theta varies from 0 to pi. Phi varies from 0 to 2 pi. If you put r equal to a, you get 10 a square plus 5 e to the power minus r into a square. Sin theta, if you integrate minus cos theta, limits from 0 to pi, d phi if you integrate you get phi between 0 and 2 pi. Here also in e to the power minus r also we have to replace r by a so that it becomes e to the power minus a. So this becomes now what 10 a square plus 5 e to the power minus a square into 2 into 2 pi. So many coulombs. This is one way of doing. The other one way of doing is by using the right hand side of divergence theorem where we do volume integration. I'll tell you the technique, correct? At home you verify it, correct? Alternate technique also I teach you. Alternate technique, alternate method. Say Q is equal to closed surface integral vector d dot ds. This closed surface integral is equivalent to a volume integral divergence of d dv. This is in accordance with divergence theorem. This is by applying divergence theorem. This is by applying divergence theorem. This is by applying divergence theorem. This implies Q is equal to volume integral is a triple integral. R varies from 0 to a, theta varies from 0 to pi, phi varies from 0 to 2 pi. Divergence of vector d is what? 40 r minus 5 e to the power minus r plus 10 e to the power minus r divided by r. This is the expression for divergence of vector d. You have done in part a. What is dv? Dv is r square sin theta, r square sin theta dr d theta d phi. So this integration you have to do it, integration by parts also you have to do, because r square gets multiplied by to the power minus r. This is given as homework to you. You do this integration, you will get the same result as you got by doing closed surface integral of vector d dot ds. This is given as a homework for you. Please try it out. Next problem. An infinitely long conductor of density rho l coulombs per meter produces an electric field. Show the divergence of this electric field is zero everywhere. Solution. See, this problem requires memory in the sense you must know what is the expression for electric field intensity produced by an infinite line charge. The electric field intensity produced by an infinite line charge is vector E is equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon rho into A rho cap volts per meter. I repeat. This is the expression for electric field intensity produced by an infinite line charge. Okay. What you have to show? We have to show divergence of this vector is zero. And the problem is in spherical coordinates. Sorry, in cylindrical coordinates. In cylindrical coordinates, what are the coordinates? Rho, phi and z. In a cylindrical coordinate system, we have the rho, phi and z as the coordinates. Right? Divergence of vector E is what? 1 by rho, dou by dou rho, acting on rho into E rho, plus 1 by rho, dou E phi by dou phi, plus dou ez by dou z. This is the expression for divergence of vector E in a cylindrical coordinate system. I repeat. Please read the problem. An infinitely long conductor of density rho l coulombs per meter produces an electric field. Show that divergence of this field is zero everywhere. The problem is in a cylindrical coordinate system. Here you have to recall this expression. This is the expression for electric field intensity produced by an infinite length charge. Next, divergence of vector E. This is the component in rho direction. This is a component for phi direction. This is a component for z direction. Or this, like, you know, divergence of vector E in a Cartesian coordinate system will have components in x, y, and z. Similarly, this is in rho direction, this is in phi direction, and this is in z direction. Only E rho is present. Coefficient of A rho cap here, E rho. What is E rho? E rho is nothing but, E rho is nothing but rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon into rho. What is E phi? E phi is 0. What is E z? E z is 0. Why E phi and E z are 0? Because there are no unit vectors A phi cap and A z cap in the expression for electric field intensity. Now differentiate this. This implies divergence of vector E is equal to 1 by rho, dou by dou rho, rho into rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon into rho. Rho gets cancelled. So rho L by 2 pi epsilon is a constant. So we get what? 1 by dou rho operating on rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon. Rho L by 2 pi epsilon is a constant. If you differentiate that with respect to rho, the result is 0. So 1 by rho into 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, divergence of vector E is 0 for an infinitely long conductor of length. In length is infinity, density is what? Rho L coulombs per meter. If divergence of vector E is 0, divergence of vector D should also be 0. Because vector D and vector E are related as per the expression, vector D is equal to epsilon into vector E. Thank you.